eSportBets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. eSportBets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
And welcome back, everybody, to Room on Fire. We have LDLC playing Reason in a best-of-one game here for the SLTV Starseries Season 10. Thank you so much for joining us, and also thanks for going crazy in the chat. Semla, though, how are you doing? Are you still around?
Yeah, I'm here, man. Your timing couldn't have been better.
Nice.
You know, just finished listening to Method Man.
Excellent. You know what I realized just in this break?
What's up?
That so normally during a normal evening, I think this goes to both Semler and I, all of you guys watching here. You always hope that it's going to be a good game, the show is going to be good, and that, you know, all of you people choosing to spend, you know, 4, 5, 6 hours an evening with us, that you're going to walk away from the evening feeling like you've been entertained and it's been worth your while, right? That's like a basic hope, I think, for anyone doing streaming on Twitch or anywhere else, really. And then you realize that all you have to do to keep people entertained is play Sandstorm every once in a while. I don't know why. Somehow it's very good because it means the sort of the standard's really low, but at the same time, it's a little bit depressing, right? Goddamn Sandstorm. It'll never go away, will it? But, yeah, we oblige. We gotta do it. We gotta do it every once in a while, right? To keep the crowd happy.
Yeah, man. Oh. Apparently, Epsilon just dropped me spoons.
The what? They did?
Yeah.
Were they picking up instead?
FXO.
Oh, okay. So that's potentially a very big change.
That was a short stay there for me, Stu. Wasn't on the team for too long there. What was it, a month?
Yeah, it wasn't all that long, and as I recall, they brought him in kind of with the reasoning that since he was a young player and a relatively untested one, they thought they could sort of mold him into whatever they felt like, but maybe it was enough for them to find out that it wasn't what they were looking for. I mean, that can happen.
It can happen. It's just interesting, especially... I mean, you've got teams that have stuck with it, who have stuck with those players that they saw potential in, right? So LDLC is the first example that comes to mind. Talking with Apex, you know, when they decided to stick with Uzi, you know, everybody's like, okay, you know, they're gonna bring on Shoxi when Shoxi is out from Titan, and LDLC were like, no, we're keeping our lineup. This is gonna be it. And Uzi, you know, he may not be a top fragger, but we feel like he's got the right mentality, and he's the guy who's going to put in the hard work and get better. And now look at Uzi. I mean, just in the last few matches that we've watched for LDLC, he's won several clutch rounds for him. He's done a lot of good work as far as frags are concerned. I mean, this guy has definitely, you know, improved quite a bit. So it's interesting to me to see that Epsilon, you know, they bring on a guy saying, well, we're gonna do the same, right? We're going to form him into something that we need him to be for us to really dominate. Well, and they were just like, nah, too much work.
Well, maybe it could be that it's too much work, but it could also just be that, you know, he somehow has the wrong mentality that, you know, you can try and mold or you know, influence somebody, but if it doesn't work within... I mean, I think you can tell within a couple of weeks whether or not that person is susceptible to training or not. And if they're not, then I actually don't blame them for not wanting to spend any more time. And I think, you know... VODS Pro, the Polish team, did kind of the same thing. They had Pete and Hyper, and then they had Snacks and Bailey. Like, they went through a number of players just to try and test out who would work, and obviously they made the right choice eventually, but Pete and Hyper sort of got, you know, disposed of pretty quickly.
That's true. There was quite a bit of movement around VP. I mean, Snacks and Bailey, we all know the story there. I mean, hell, the team has won a major, and all in large part due to Snacks and Bialy's contributions. So that was a big call here from VP, and it paid off. I mean, we just have to see. I mean, I think the article that's been released right now, you know, with a more to follow ... at the end of it, you know, is pretty spare. Like, they didn't really give any information as to why the change was made. It's just, you know, apparently Shoxi's revealed that Mistu is out and FXO is in.
All right.
So you know, we shall see. We'll see if we can get any kind of further information as to why they decided to make the change.
It could be a call on Mistu's own part as well. It could be that he just felt like, this isn't my thing, you know, going to LANs and performing and everything else. Like, you know, maybe being at DreamHack Valencia was a wake-up call for him to say, I'm not really, you know, I'm not at the same level, or I don't want to be. So we'll have to wait, I think, until we know something else. Otherwise, it's really just all speculation. Go through here. LDLC right now, as far as I can tell, are sixth in the group right now with 3 wins, 0 ties, and 2 losses. So doing reasonably well. I mean, they're still in the fight here to try and see if they can make it to the finals. Of course, it's going to be the top 4 teams who make it to your SLTV finals. That's how it's always been. Mm-hmm. Reason, on the other hand, are much lower on the board. The point difference, the LDLC have 9 points and Reason are down to 6 and have actually lost 6 games and only won 2. So I think that is also the reason why, if you look at CSGO Lounge, where it's actually too late to bet on this game now, but if you have bet on them, you will have noticed that LDLC had a pretty massive, you know, lead. I think it was like 87% in favor of LDLC and maybe 13% in favor of Reason, mm-hmm. which is, I don't even think that's necessarily unreasonable, but I still think it's very dangerous to go all in a game like this. So yeah, I think we've said this before, guys, and fair warning is being given again here now. When you have best of one online games, even if the odds are fair, betting on LDLC at this point can still be pretty dangerous, because the throwback is so little, you basically have to invest really expensive skins. And I mean, we saw what USSR did to ESG just before. They had a really great start. They won the first 4 rounds. The fact that they then lost almost everything since then is, you know, it could have gone differently.
It could have, if they'd have just managed to maintain a bit of the momentum for themselves and not let ESG get a bank going for them. I think that was the big thing. Once ESG got those double ops in play, it really started to kind of devolve from there. One thing to note is that, Reason, you know, they've pretty much got a black streak going in the Star Series group phase so far. But their one win in recent memory, or at least in the recent statistics, has been against Berserk. As far as the rest of it, you know, they've lost twice to ESG, once to Fnatic, and once to Titan. So it seems to me like they've really run into the upper echelon of teams, and so far in their group stage, you know, that they haven't had the best luck with that, and that, you know, they'll have an opportunity to, I don't want to say farm up points on some of the lesser top teams, but still, you know, they may be able to come back and actually make a run for it in the end. What would be excellent for Reason is obviously getting a good start here and winning against LDLC. That would be a point that would go a long way towards getting them closer to that 4th spot.
Absolutely would. It's going to be a really tough fight, but the fact that we're on Dust 2, I think, is really good for Reason. They have Kevin, who's quite a strong AWPer. Of course, LDLC have Kaylee, who is, I would say, a very, very competent AWPer as well. So I'm not saying Kevin is going to be able to just outright out of Kevin, Kaylee, but if it is, you know, if a map is going to do it, it might just be Dust 2, where you have a chance to get that sort of stuff working. If you're just joining us, then welcome to the stream here. This is the SLTV Style Series Season 10, and you're at Room on Fire. I'm Anders, with me is Summer, of course, and we are just waiting for the last 2 players from LDLC. Then we will be live with this game on Dust 2. Again, a huge thanks to all of you for tuning in. I hope you guys are going to follow and subscribe to the channel, help us out a little bit. I think we're almost at 130,000, and, you know, the higher we get, well, you know, the more popular we're going to try and see if we can make Counter-Strike. That's secretly, or maybe not so secretly now that I'm saying it, but that's the goal with this channel. We just want to see if we can push this game as far as humanly possible, basically.
Exactly. The higher up we get on the Twitch list, the more attention everything we do here gets. And that's the thing. So I think right now we're waiting on Happy and Apex, so we'll see there. We're approaching 15 minutes past the hour. One thing to note, or one thing, you know, that you've noticed in recent time, at least, is that these games have been starting more or less on time. It's like that now I'm actually kind of like a little, like, I find myself actually getting annoyed. I'm like, wait a second, you know, we're 10 minutes late here. What's going on? When it used to be, you know, that was just standard. Like, you waited 15 minutes. People wouldn't even show up to watch the game until 15 minutes past the hour, because they knew that it would take that long for the players to get in the server. Now, these days, you know, we're so used to everything going, you know, on the minute, everybody ready, all that sort of thing, that when a team is, like, even just, like, 10 minutes late, you're like, what the hell is going on?
Yeah, it's true. Those were the bad old days of Global Offensive and Counter-Strike in general, I think, when it was surprising if a game started with you know, just a 10 or 20 minute delay. We've been used to something different. I think, you know, SLTV should get a lot of credit for putting that type of work in, really making sure that they get the teams on, they test the servers, they do the map veto on time, they're really keeping them close here. And that's really good. I mean, that's what you need if you want things to run smoothly. Otherwise, If you leave it up to the teams, things are going to get really awkward.
I think we have to give a big shout out to Panda, really. Yes. The head admin for SLTV, the guy who is actually the one organizing these matches on a weekly, daily basis, making sure that the bans and picks and everything are done on time. It's all down to him that this is running so smoothly. So, you know, just big shout outs to the admins. Excuse me, because it's not often that the admins get a lot of attention, right? You know, it's because of them that these tournaments run so smoothly. So we have to, we got to give them their due every once in a while. Give a shout out.
And if you guys want to spend your time waiting here, we do have one more person on, so we just need the last player, and then I think he's happy. He will be good to go. But if you guys want to spend your time productively here, you can go and click the links that are at the bottom of the stream, which is the raffle that we'll be doing on Wednesday with Case King for our own Case King of the Hill tournament called by Alpenfruit. If you guys want to participate in that, then you just click the Facebook link, you click like. Last week we gave away a CPU cooler and also a headset. This week we're giving away a really, really nice power supply, so you guys definitely want to be a part of that, because actually power supplies and the quality of them is pretty important, and this one is definitely top notch. So go and participate, and we won't just be doing it last week and this week. We'll be doing this for the next 13 weeks. So if you like the page now, you are basically in for the raffle for the next 13 weeks. So it's pretty easy stuff.
And we should be doing one like weekly, and this is going to carry over, right? So touching on that power supply, I think it's one of the best on the market right now. So it's pretty slick if you can actually manage to pick that up. So it's worth a click, and just takes 2 seconds. The other thing that we have at the bottom of the page now that we just recently put in is our YouTube page, where all of the match VODs are listed. They get loaded as soon as we're done casting. By the end of the night, bam, we've got all the VODs up on YouTube. So if you miss a match, if there was a match that you really wanted to see and you don't want to go through the Twitch VOD and click around on the bar and try and find the point where the match starts, all that annoying bullshit that comes with Twitch VODs, you can go to the YouTube page. It's right on the link right there, and we have everything there. It's all organized, and, we're just looking to try and make it easy for you guys to actually catch the matches that you want to see.
Exactly, and obviously a big thanks to our YouTube video editing team that helps us out afterwards. That's really great that we can get some help with that. So, we're going to try and keep that as active as possible. Now the match has actually restarted, and I'm wondering if they are all here, because I did this one time before, but it feels like they're all pretty much at their computer. So welcome to the game once again. And speaking of which, if you are on YouTube and you're watching this as a VOD, then thank you for tuning in. It's going to be LDLC versus Reason Gaming here at Room on Fire. So enjoy the show. Reason starting on the Terra side, and a really aggressive move here from LDLC. Look at this on short, Samla.
Yeah, three guys pushing up short like this. They're really looking to catch them off guard at top mid. Uzi keeping an eye on mid, though, and he would have told his teammates that they don't actually see anybody. So instead, LDLC are looking towards lower dark, hoping to catch somebody there. Reason Gaming right now, they've managed to sneak a man out onto long, though. That's MSL taking point. He's going to be starting to look towards that A site, see if he can get any eyes on the defense, get a feel for what LDLC are doing. As right now, Reason Gaming, I mean, they're spread out, but they haven't really bumped into anybody from LDLC yet, apart from Uzi taking a bit of damage to start.
I'm actually a really big fan of this setup from LDLC. There are a few ways I can think of it going really horribly wrong. It's like if you get spotted from lower dark and some guy from mid starts throwing grenades onto short where you are, you could take a lot of damage. But other than that, if you just think about it, they're in the middle of the map. They can go to A or B just as fast, and either retake is going to be really quick. In fact, the fact that they're rotating back towards the A bombsite now is going to be potentially detrimental once this push happens towards the B bombsite. They're just leaving Hunden down here to make a lot of noise, and now they give up the B bombsite basically for free. Uzi just has to wait for some backup. Kaylee making a lot of noise with Maniac coming up here through Upper Dark, and the bomb is going to go down, and Hunden coming in from behind. He's going to have to run to help his teammates here.
Yeah, he has to get in there very quickly, but this is so much time being bought right now for Reason Gaming. The bomb has been down for a while, and LDLC, they still haven't gotten a kill. Kev has got one, but the flank is coming in from Hunden on upper. They just need to hold on the site, and they aren't doing it. It is all down to Hunden now, and his flank falls apart because his teammates just couldn't hold.
So, a great take of the bomb site, and then a really good retake of the bomb site. Nice play from LDLC. Really a smooth retake. I'm not sure why that was so easy for them, especially when Kevin got that first kill. I'm a little bit sad that Kevin re-peaked, though. I understand he wanted to get the second kill and really pick it up, but it felt like that wasn't even necessary. But LDLC off to a good start here.
Yeah, surprising how many people from LDLC actually went through there. That was the advantage of them holding up on short like that. Very cool play, because if they lose A, they have control of short and they go for the retake off of short and long, right? If they lose B, because Uzi is the only man in there, and Uzi was holding at window, so he's only looking to see to get the information. This was like all about the retake for LDLC. He just wants the info. He stays alive. And then because the guys are already on short, they can get into upper dark and put the pressure on Reason Gaming so quickly. So that was a very cool pistol strat coming out from LDLC. Excellent way to hold on Dust 2.
I absolutely agree, and obviously it has its... I think that sort of strat is really, really vulnerable if the other team knows you're doing it. But if you show it out every once in a while, how can they? Unless they go scouting, and you know, you kind of want them to go scouting at that point, because you got three people waiting in the middle and can take some pretty good duels. Now coming up from behind as well as Maniac, so Kevin and Tensky here, they're going to be on borrowed time, in fact. Maniac just sort of takes it away from them, and there it is. Nobody dying on LDLC side, and we're going to move in already to the third round where they do pick up AKs already, which means there's going to be no AWP on Kevin, which I'm a little bit of, you know, it's a little bit of a shame, but I understand why they're doing this anyway, because they obviously know LDLC won't have one either, so it sort of makes sense.
Yeah, and the other thing is that basically they just want to try and keep the pressure up, but Apex playing his style, Kaylee there to support from mid as well, that's the bomb dropped at the top of mid. MSL is going to be able to pick that back up again. But right there, right from the start, LDLC, they wanted to strike Reason Gaming and just make sure that they were off balance. And that's LDLC style. Apex going for a push up mid like that, just getting a kill. That's all LDLC.
Yeah, this round seemed like the Danes basically, and speaking as a Dane, you know, I'm sorry to say it, but it seems like they were just basically taking this round a little bit too, you know, lightly. They were just like, oh, all right, guys, we got some guns. Let's just go to, you know, middle, see what happens. We'll make up our minds eventually. And the Frenchmen, they were really, really aggressive. That middle peak there, Kaylee and Apex picking up a kill each just completely shut them down. So I don't know. I think they need to wake up a little bit here. You can't go into a game like that. The two people that got picked off basically looked like they had no idea what was happening.
That was pretty much it. Kaylee and Apex just working so well together. They actually had three guys at mid, I believe, for LDLC, so they had it all covered. If it came down to the range fight, LDLC just went for it. That's kind of that actually makes me feel like LDLC are just taking advantage of the fact that you take so little damage through mid doors. Now, as well, they didn't have to worry about an AWP picking them off, and that's the only rifle that can really do significant damage. So they just were willing to take the fight, stack it up, and go. I mean, LDLC, this is just their style. Apex is the kind of guy who is always, you always have to worry about him pushing out aggressively here, there, everywhere, and just, you know, destroying your team single-handedly.
And it is sort of hard to play against. I mean, catch on quick enough. It may be that, especially if they have an AWP, maybe that they can sort of just try and hold angles and hope to catch off someone like Apex if he's going to peek, but They need to realize, otherwise it's not really going to work out right now. It's 4-0 for LDLC, which is a really good start. It's not completely overpowering, and there's Kevin picking up the AWP, so that is really good news, I think. The question is if it's going to make a difference or not, because we still have Kaylee on the other side, who looks like he's actually not going to be running for the middle. He wants to run out long instead, and Kevin trying to see if he can pick someone off, not going to take the shot. A little bit too worried about Kaylee on the other side, and I don't blame him.
It doesn't seem like he wants to force the issue. And for now, LDLC, two guys holding on the B site, one up on short. So that's a good position right now for Kaylee to be in, actually, if he can catch somebody peeking up here. Or even if he wants to try and get really aggressive and push and look for a lower dark shot. But right now, Kaylee just seems content. LDLC, after that very aggressive round in the fourth, or rather the third, have just decided, okay, well, we've gone for the aggression. It worked. We got a free round. Now we're just going to hold. We're going to change up the pace.
Oh, Hunden going to take down Kaylee up on short. Molotov going to come up for MSL. Actually not going to be burned by that, so Maniac throwing a little bit too short. That's a real shame because he knows he's there. He spotted the top of his face. Now Smoke going to come up, and MSL just wants to try and see if he can actually just buy time. And he will take down another player there. Very nicely done. Hunden picking up the second kill, takes down Apex, and we're back into a 4-on-2. Happy and Uzi are left.
And just like that, Kaylee, that aggressive position, holding it solo as well, came back to bite him. One good flash was all it took to actually root him out of there, and then it just devolves from that point forward. LDLC are getting overrun. Kev finds a shot in CT. That's Happy now taken out, and it's all down to Uzi, who's alive. As far as the money is concerned, LDLC, they don't really care if they lose this gun or not. It's more important for LDLC to just try and get some rifles off of Reason Gaming. So that's why Uzi, he's really just trying to get in here and see if he can catch somebody off guard. But MSL is going to get the kill, lives with 6 HP. Uzi was robbed.
Yes, that I think that's the correct term here. Now we're moving into the sixth round. Apex with 7-1-1, just dying the one time here and a pretty good ratio. But this is a really good round from Reason Gaming and an encouraging one for them as well, probably. And even though Kevin he can afford armor, but he hasn't purchased any yet, just going to go for the straight mid peak here and not going to take the shot. But they're going to boost up in the middle, and this is some nice play. I love this idea. But they may get caught. Apex falling down, and they still pick up the kill. A little bit of a lost opportunity there for Reason.
Yeah, but MSL, has, in the meantime, has managed to pick up the defense on B. He's caught Happy out. A little bit of a pop flash comes in, but Apex is so low, he can't do anything about that. They're just running in one at a time. Uzi and Apex get caught on the site, and now, once again, LDLC are down two guys for a retake situation. At this point, LDLC don't have so much money yet left that they need to be throwing away rifles. Like, at this point, I want to see them just back off, get out of there, hold on to the guns.
I agree, absolutely. I think that's the right call you're making here, because KD's got $200, but if they save even one of these two rifles, they can still buy for the next round, and they'll be off to a fine round. It back from that, I actually thought they would have lost this round just because of the lost guy in the middle. It felt like they gave away a big opportunity, and sometimes it could be pretty hard to come back from that. Good stuff, though. And just a quick point out, Semler, here, because you know you're living in Sweden now, so you got to learn at least a little bit of Scandinavian. If you don't know already, and I guess just in general, if you're like a Game of Thrones fan but you're not from Scandinavia, then Hunden is actually directly translated into English would be the Hound.
The Hound, yeah. It's like Skurk is the bear. Bjorn?
Yeah, well, Bjorn is just a great name, isn't it? That's so manly.
That, yeah, it's hard to top that, really.
And Bjorn, repeat. Oh, Kevin. Okay, repeating the third time against two people in the middle is a little bit creepy, but Apex moving up very aggressively. Here's that aggressive style you were talking about, Semler, and it shuts down the first player. They kill one on long. Kevin is going to pick up a kill, but it might be too late. Apex and Kaylee doing exceptional work early here in the seventh round.
Apex playing that down to a T. He read them like a book. Kev through the smoke picks off Maniac, though. Point blank at A house. Nice kill there. This is actually shaking things up here for LDLC, because they went from having a two-man advantage on the CT side to now only having that one-man advantage, and Kaylee's already taken a lot of damage. But look at Uzi now just peeking forward into upper dark. They want to figure out, LDLC, where exactly Reason Gaming are holed up, and they don't really have any information to go off of right now. Apex just barely misses them making their way up onto Cat, and he's not close enough to be able to hear them jumping around either. This is all going to be down to Kaylee now, who is focused on long. He could get flanked out before he even knows what's going on.
Yeah, Uzi is coming up. Oh, he's going to go back. If Uzi kept going on short here, that would probably win the round for LDLC, but they can't really know that. As you said, they don't have the information. Although I do like the fact that they put Uzi in this position to try and get information, because obviously that's what they're trying to do at this point. Smoke's going to go off, and that really does tip their hand. Now Kaylee knows that something is up. The bomb is going to go down. Uzi's going to get up from short. I think they're still not in a great position here. Kevin misses a shot, and that pretty is going to cost him his life here. Uzi getting ready. Grenade is going to fall out. He hasn't actually taken much damage yet, so he's going to get one more chance to get a shot in. Misses that one, and now Uzi taking a long time and leaving now PNX alone in a 1-on-3, and Reason Gaming going to be very tough for them to come up with a win here. He's going to peek against both of them and goes down accordingly. But I actually think Kevin could have maybe won that. I mean, he'd already done a lot, but if he got the kill on Uzi, it would have been a different round anyway.
Them sneaking onto the site like that is... I mean, it's just a testament to how good LDLC are right now with the retakes. For them to be able to just walk in, after Reason Gaming have managed to hold on, or like get onto that site, get the plant, they walk in without anybody actually dying. Like, that's actually really good from LDLC. And Kaylee now mid... This is just a total lack of respect from LDLC. Apex pushing around doing what he wants. Kaylee willing to re-peek and pick off a guy. Like, this is disgusting.
It is really, really good, that initial peek on Kevin. But I really think now, you know, we're now 8 rounds into the game, and I think now Reason Gaming should have been able to learn a little bit about the way LDLC are playing. They shouldn't have been surprised about Kaylee peeking again, and Hunden was just sort of running down the middle with a grenade out, which is not the ideal situation. Tensky, though, doing great work to try and get back into it, takes down Happy. But I think the Danes, they need to wake up a little bit more, because actually, some of what LDLC is doing is, I don't want to say predictable, but they are following a very aggressive pattern. So if they just expect... be able to read a lot of what's happening here. Oh, Kaylee, if he's going to jump down middle in a second here, because they're pushing out middle, he might just fall off this ledge and try and shoot them as they come out. That'd be quite an action-packed moment. I'm waiting for it, Kaylee.
He'd be so exposed if he does. That would be suicide if he does. He's going to do it. There's the flash, but the smoke is down. The timing working out here for Reason Gaming. They've got that smoke to block Kaylee off. Kaylee looking for an angle through. Uzi's on that B site. He gets caught, though. He does take one with him, brings it back to a 2-on-2. This is still feasible here for LDLC. That they can come out ahead in. Maniac now rotating through T-spawn into upper dark, but we already have PNX waiting for him there.
Yeah, and PNX missing an easy shot. That's a really, really unfortunate, but I'm glad he falls back then. Now they might as well just try and focus on what they can do inside this site. Kaney peeking the window. It's going to go down. It's up to Maniac, taking a lot of damage and just needs to fall away. He's going to run right into the shot. And the Danes do come out on top, which is good news for them. The bad news is LDLC can still buy. So, I mean, 5-3, I actually don't think LDLC need much more than 5 rounds on the CT side here. I think if they get more than 5 rounds, Reason is going to be in a lot of trouble. So I'm not even worried a little bit for LDLC at this point.
I guess this is a new theme for the day here. Double off play for Reason Gaming on the T side. This is really, I mean, we're seeing it a lot today for some reason, but this is not something that you see very often for the T side. So MSL, it's the duel at long. Kaylee takes a different angle and comes out on top. MSL not expecting him to be pushed out that far. So a nice play there by Kaylee, just with the mind games at this point, switching it up.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, now you got to wonder if the double up setup is going to mean anything, or if LDLC are going to assume that's the one up down. Maybe they won't have another one, but not even sure it matters at this point. Reason Gaming, I think they've shown that the 3 rounds they have so far have been down mainly to sort of individual plays, not so much because of any really, really great decision making on their side. So if they can keep making great individual plays, maybe they have a chance here, but that is a really tough way to play a game.
That's a tough call, right? I mean, right now it's they need to make the right call, and they also need to get the entry kills, and that's a lot to ask from when you're facing off against LDLC, who seems so on point right now with their defense.
Take a look at what Happy's doing here. This flash is really, really great. It just pops right at the top of the entrance to the B-bomb site. We'll take the middle reel first because Uzi's going to face a lot of challenges. He's actually getting shot down quite a bit. He goes down. There's the flashbang in. Happy's going to peek right afterwards. And look how well it works. Takes down PNX and leaves Kevin alone now in a 1-on-2. That flashbang was golden. Otherwise, it would have been a 2-on-2. Bomb goes down. Kevin goes for the peek and he misses the flick. And they lose the round. Maniac with a triple kill, and LDLC come out on top just fine.
Can he not defuse? Okay, yes, he can defuse. Yeah. I was about to say, that was a little odd there. Looks like we lost Apex in the meantime, so... That was a great decision by Happy in particular, because he just shut down one of the flanks, right, that was going to come in, one of the pincers of that play. You know, if he loses sight and he knows how many people are rushing up B slope, he does the math in his head and he's like, okay, there's got to be one guy left. Where could he be? Upper dark, maybe, rushes in and actually gets the punish on that. That allowed for a lot of confusion, actually, on Reason's side. At that point, they've got to worry about the man in upper dark, but also about the guys closing in from CT spawn. So Reason not able to get into the site fast enough, they get flanked, and that's not going to be good here, seeing as how we were just talking about LDLC needing to be stopped at 5 rounds.
I think one of the position that he was holding here is what we sometimes refer to as basically a trigger-based position. There's one in the middle as well where you're holding down the side of the wall here. And because you can't see anything yourself, I mean, obviously this position doesn't make any sense if you go and peek first and then throw the flashbang. You got to just wait for a trigger, and it could be an audio trigger, it could be the other team throwing flashbangs. I think this time the trigger was Reason pushing into middle and killing Uzi, and they were like, oh hell, well, I kind of gotta do something now, otherwise I'm gonna get stuck in the corner. But the flashbang is just, it worked so well, and obviously PNX wasn't quite ready for it, so just great play. Now we have one guy disconnecting from LDLC, which is unfortunate. Hopefully he's gonna be right back and we'll be good to go. But the break gives us a bit of a moment here to welcome all the newcomers to the stream, and hope you guys will click that follow button. It really helps us out a lot, and you can also go and follow us on Twitter. The links are in the chat. I just typed the command there, so there we go. And also our sponsors page, you should go and check out Case King there, facebook.com/CaseKingGaming. If you like that page, you can participate in the raffle for the next 13 weeks. So definitely go and do that. It's a great chance to win all sorts of cool stuff. This week, it's a really cool power supply, which will, I mean, almost no matter what computer you have, it'll be enough power to sort it out, I think.
Pretty much. I think it's 1,300 watts.
Yeah. So
that's a lot of power.
unless you're like a case modding expert that has put, like, I don't know, a disco inside his PC with all sorts of lights, maybe you'll need more power somehow, but other than that, it should be all right. If you have a microwave inside your computer, then maybe you're going to need like an extra power supply to fund that. All right, we're back in the game, and it's into the 10th round here. Really good start for LDLC, as predicted by pretty much every human being alive. They are but definitely the better team here. And Reason, I mean, the best of one game, they can come out on top, but it's not going to be easy.
I'm getting trolled by Fetish at the same time.
Oh.
So another Dane for all of you guys. Yeah, I'm sure you all know who Fetish is, in-game leader of Dignitas. Saying that I'm mispronouncing words, and all of a sudden when I say shot, it sounds like shit. So,
well, just to ask, when is the last time Dignitas played?
They've all been on vacation, man. They've all been on vacation. AC's been around, Fetish has been around, but I think Sipnix was on vacation. Device went and traveled somewhere, so they haven't played for like the past 2 weeks at least.
I feel like we need to see them more in action. Though Kaylee's going to get some action here. He actually misses the shot, so pretty good bait coming out from Reason. But all it really does is force Kaylee back to the next corner, and they don't gain a lot of map control from doing that. But at least they know what side of the map he's on, and maybe they can use that for some sort of push. If they want to go for a B push, though, that could be painful. Flash in. Is Uzi going to peek behind it? Yes, he will. And the Danes, again, apparently very vulnerable to flashbangs, just going down. Now they're going to be rushing into the B bomb side, and Happy has a new great position, and this is just about timing, and Happy has the perfect timing. Easy peasy lemon squeezy, and Reason are gone. Not a single person from LDLC dies, and it's 7-3.
Oh, that was painful. That was so painful for Reason Gaming. Happy timed that down to a T as well. As soon as his teammates started taking fire, OP peeks out, and it's just like they line up perfectly for him. But what was really nice was the flash at the beginning, as you're right. You know, like them chucking LDLC, putting that flash over mid doors like that completely caught Reason Gaming off guard. Both players there for Reason Gaming were completely flashed. So, I mean, they could have even been greedy and stuck around. But I like how Uzi, I believe it was Uzi, just, you know, got the kill and then backed off again.
Yeah, I mean, they're really simple type of holds coming out. You know, the 1-2 flash combo or Happy hiding in the corner. It's not like it's super elaborate with, you know, oh, we're going to throw really great Molotovs and then we're going to force them in a corner and so on and so forth. It's really just 1-2 punch and then it just happens. But I really appreciate that. I think that's a good idea because they're executing them so well. The timing is good. The communication is obviously good for LDLC. And it's just a real pleasure to watch at this point. 8-3, and we're moving into the 12th round.
Now we have to see Reason actually start chaining some rounds together here, because it's starting to get pretty far out of control. LDLC, now they're going to come out ahead in rounds in this half, no matter what Reason do at this point. LDLC have at least 8 rounds on the CT side. Great flash in by Tenski, though, that aggression to punish the stack, and LDLC, they managed to turn it around. Apex gets a kill right back.
Yeah, he does. He then goes down to Tenski, leaving Happy alone towards the B bomb site. Bomb is going to go down, but smart by Happy, doesn't push in. He realized, well, the retake coming in with Kaylee and Maniac, and actually I think right now they're waiting for Kaylee trying and get a pick off anyone crossing over. When that doesn't happen, they then decide to sort of commit to it. Kevin in the middle has to just wait. Why is he challenging? That was a very, very bad move. He could have just waited. They saw him. He was already going to be a big factor either way. Now they're going to be after trying to see if they can hold this once again. Flashbang goes in. Hunden is waiting right here. Takes down. Actually, that's MSL taking down Maniac. And then he's going to re-peek again. Now it's back into a 2-on-2. They should still have this. Tenski walking right behind, but Kaylee takes him down. I'm not sure there's enough time, but that is still a great retake coming out from LDLC. They will, or at least Katie will explode. So the Danes sort of did it anyway, but that is, I don't know. I think they did a lot of mistakes this round. Reason, LDLC could have won that round.
LDLC could have won that round. It just comes down to whether Tenski was able to get there fast enough. And Kaylee's timing with that was pretty sick. You wish that Happy had just gone in and gone straight for the defuse with so little time left on that bomb. But they didn't actually know until Kaylee pulled a 180 and then just flick shot Tenski. So, well, Reason they get the round, and I think that's the most important thing, but they don't have much money going into it. That them losing every member of their team there, that hurt them so much. Now they just don't have a whole lot as far as nades or rifles go.
They really don't, but I do want to give some credit to Reason here, because this round they actually did something that's very clever. Even though they lost a person early on, you can clearly see that the Danish team were expecting an aggressive push from LDLC, and they had a setup that was sort of planned for it. Now they're going to be walking down middle, and Hunda not realizing there's going to be someone there, which I guess that kind of takes away from what I just said. But early in the round, they were prepared for what LDLC were doing, and that's, even if they're going to lose this game, it's nice to see them making adjustments based on what the other team is doing, because that's something a team has to be able to do.
Absolutely. And this was a very cool play by LDLC. Rather than go for the mid play aggression, they're like, okay, we'll push into upper dark. They get a massive amount of information, and they get a free kill out of it as well. And now they're pushing in, just poking at Reason Gaming and T-Spawn. Uzi and Happy, they're here. And look at this. Uzi sets up on the crate. He's going to pick up one. This is such a tough situation right now for Kev. That kill on Happy, you have to get the headshot. And it's just not going to be good enough. Happy actually gets rid of him with a nade. they're single-handedly just shutting down Raisin Gaming right now.
Yeah, Happy just surprised that his time in Dust 2 Deathmatch actually paid off, because that's like one of the only times you're going to be practicing shooting these angles in the T-spawn is like Deathmatch. And then this game, apparently. 9-4 is a pretty overwhelming lead, and there's no money left for Reason, so this is going to be very likely 11, well, it could be 11-4 here for the first half.
It could be, Reason, they're broke right now. They have to go for pistols, and they're not going to have a whole lot of money to work with again in the last round of the half. Good flashes leading into that B site. Happy is about to get a good pop flash for himself, though, and they get completely obliterated. Uzi just shuts them down. Not a hope here for Reason Gaming. They just ran into a brick wall head first.
Oh, Kevin has a little bit of a sense of humor and just looks down at the grenade that lands straight on his ankles, and it's going to be 10-4 here. They will be able to buy, but as I said, it's not going to be a lot. That's why I said I thought it was going to be 11-4, because they just don't really have the equipment to deal with the punishment that they are receiving from LDLC at the moment. I mean, I think, as I said earlier, I think the score, the prediction that people have made on CSGO Lounge for 87 and 13 was the betting tendency. I think that was fairly accurate.
Agreed. Although now PMX decides to wake up and get 2 sick kills on long with a Galil, no less. Tenski waiting for the rotation out of Uzi, manages to catch him. Happy now going to be slowed down because he has to worry about lower dark when he goes through mid, but he's in a 1-on-4, so there isn't really a hope in hell here for Happy to really do anything. MSL is already scoped up, looking towards short, and then Happy just gives himself to him. So end score 10-5 for LDLC going into the second half now when they play on their T side. I think that that prediction from the community, or the betting community at least, was pretty spot on at this point.
Yeah, it feels like it. 10-5 is, they can come back from it. We've seen that happen on the CT side of Dust too, but I feel like it's still very unlikely. So until it actually happens, I think we can just credit LDLC with still playing really well. And seems like every time we see them in the last couple of weeks here, they've just been steadily improving. And that's really good news. They're a great team, and we're seeing it right here. Of course, later on, we're going to be seeing LDLC again. They'll be playing up against ESG, and then ESG is going to be playing Epsilon. So we have a lot of Counter-Strike coming up for you guys, but if you're just joining us, then welcome to the channel. This is Room on Fire. I'm Anders, with me is Summer, of course, and we are going to be ready with the second half in just 5 seconds. Remember to follow and subscribe and all that stuff, and a big thanks to all of you who have already subscribed to the channel. We really do appreciate it. It helps us keep regular content here on for Counter-Strike. And if you do want to support us in an easy way, all you have to do is click the follow button. I think we're just like 200 followers away from hitting 130,000. So if we can do that tonight, I'm going to go to bed feeling pretty well.
Pretty happy, yeah. I think we'll be fairly happy with the outcome. Now it's going to be, again, Reason Gaming just aggressively facing off mid. Kaylee and MSL trading shots. And this is still up for, I mean, we don't really know exactly where LDLC want to take this at this point. They are grouping up for short. They are going to be peeking around here, hoping to catch somebody off guard, but there is nobody holding here for Reason Gaming. They actually only have 2 guys holding over on A. So if LDLC decided to go for this A site, this would not be a bad call for them, seeing as how they already have Apex pushing out from A house.
This is going to be really hard, especially for PNX. Down towards Pit with 4 people coming for him, and he has, well, it's 1 flashbang. I'm not sure that's quite enough here. He's going to flash out and then call for help. Hunden coming in. Actually, a great opening headshot and doing good damage afterwards, but he's going to go down, and Uzi gets both those kills, and now this retake is going to be tough, especially if MSL goes down to Happy here. They are having a bit of a duel. Just 4 bullets left, and MSL, well, Kevin actually comes in with that kill. I'm not sure it's in time, though.
Still Happy. He goes down, but he's still able to trade. That's all he needs to do for his team right now. He's given his team the man advantage. They've got the bomb site now. The bomb has been planted. LDLC, this is their round to lose at this point. And I like the switch up here from Reason Gaming. You know, it's Tenski. Kev leading the way. Kev not lasting long. Tenski takes one, but that's it. 2 members live here for LDLC. They put 11 rounds on the board, and they get that second pistol round. LDLC, now, they are in a dominating position. Like, they're, for Reason Gaming, they need an act of God at this point.
Yeah, I mean, a comeback, I mean, I don't know, maybe if you had Shoxi on your team and he just went into crazy mode and killed, you know, 30 people, then maybe you'd still have a chance. But even then, at this point, LDLC just are a better team, and they have the upper hand here on this map. Not really sure. I mean, I think Reason, if they had been studying LDLC and realized that they were going to be so aggressive on the CT side, they could have made some adjustments that would have helped them out in the long run, because I mean, to give them a little bit of credit here, Reason, the Danish players, I think, have shown some promise in the sense that they've been hitting some really good shots. I mean, Tenski and his moments, Kevin with the AWP and Hunden picking up some good kills, and I think almost everyone on this team has, at one point or another, had some really good rounds where individually they've shown promise, but you can't really play a full game of Counter-Strike like that. You need, like, the team to actually work as a team eventually.
That's the thing, and well, I mean, you're talking about a team right now. LDLC are probably one of the most dangerous teams on the planet because they just come off of winning DreamHack Summer. They had to beat Hellraiser. I mean, they beat Epsilon, who beat Hellraisers in the end to get it. So LDLC are going to be feeling pretty damn confident, pretty damn fired up. And for this kind of match, LDLC, they are. I mean, this is a team that you need something like NiP to put a stop to. Like, yeah, Reason Gaming, they aren't going to be up to snuff. They don't have the experience.
It is pretty tricky, isn't it? I mean, I'm really wondering how it's going to turn out for ESG that are playing them next time. I hope they're watching the game and learning something, but then again, there's no saying if we'll be on Dust 2 or not. But at this point, yeah, you're right. LDLC are looking just very, very strong, so we'll see. And they did win DreamHack Valencia, so maybe that helps out.
It gives them that little bit of a boost. They've been boot camping as well going into it, so they are fired up. They're in a good place right now. What's coming from LDLC now is going to be a B-split, and just, well, before I can even say their names, the defense is gone. And Reason Gaming now down two guys. Hunden has been spotted out at the top of mid. He's making his way back to long, and it does look like Reason Gaming, they're going to do everything they can here to hold on to these rifles, which is exactly what they need to do. Question is, LDLC, they know exactly what's up. They don't even care about the bomb at this point. They're already spread out and hunting.
Yeah, they're not going to leave the Danes alone at all. Kevin tries to take a shot, but now they're boxed in, and I'm not sure they're going to leave this round with their rifles intact. Five members coming. One peek comes in. Kevin with a good shot, but this is still going to be pretty tricky for Reason. I like the fact that they've built a fortress for Hunden as well, just, you know, trying to see if they can at least keep him alive here. But now the bomb is going to go off. One guy goes down. PNX low on health, and these rifles, well, oh my god, what? What did we just see? That was ridiculous.
What?
Oh, I know. Man. The Counter-Strike Circus. Welcome to it, guys.
He was up there in his pillow for it, and he decided to go for it, and then that was like the most awkward spray fight ever.
Okay. That's just confusing, isn't it?
Yeah, that's also heartbreaking for Reason. Now they don't have those three guns to work with. I mean, LDLC, they realized what was going on immediately. They punished it right. So now it's just Reason Gaming. They can't really stop the match point from happening at this point. They have to eco this round, and then the following round, they're just going to be flat broke. They really aren't going to have enough to be able to put together anything really to put a stop to LDLC, apart from just landing sick shots.
Yeah, so far, I mean, just to point out another thing here, Tenski has 10 kills, and he has the most on Reason, and everybody else on LDLC has at least 15 kills, and Happy on top with 23, so there is a really big gap. Even just kills coming out right now is going to make a difference here. 21st round coming up, and we could see the end of this match really quickly with the Frenchman coming off a victory of DreamHack Valencia and just doing great work here at SLTV as well.
And their first match of the night. And this is something that we need to see out of LDLC to just establish dominance. Reason Gaming, though, big underdogs in this match. And again, LDLC are managed to sneak. They're managing to sneak their way out through mid doors. The defense has fallen back to the B side. However, both members for Reason Gaming just standing firm on that site. It's going to be the YOLO rush, though. And Apex first through the doors gets the kill. And Uzi does a 180 and picks off MSL. MSL, you can see it in the chat. He is furious. That should not have happened.
No, definitely not impressed with what's going on. PNX and Hunden left here. The bomb is down, but I see no way at all they can come back and retake this, especially not Hunden with 1-on-4 here and 4 HP. 16-5, and it is a victory for Team LDLC.com, so congratulations to them. Getting another win on the board here and moving up in the rankings. We'll see how they do against Team ESG with Delpan in the mix. That's going to be coming up and in about 15 minutes, 10, 15 minutes. So, yeah, we're ready with the next game just about then. In the meantime, stick around, watch a few ads, remember to follow the channel and all that stuff, and we'll be back. We'll put on some music you guys can listen to, and you can maybe dip in and see what's happening in the international that's also going on. But thanks for joining us, guys. We will be back soon.